Well, 2011 was a very frustrating year as far as purchases go. The three items you see purchased here all came from one supplier. Now, typically, I buy from T&K in Ohio, from RLD, Robbie, out where he is, and from CharlesRowe.com. Those guys have most of the stuff that I'm looking for. But these three items were very sad, and we'll kind of show you why right here in this video. We got the barn, the church, and the train. We'll talk more about them. Okay, the little barn was purchased in early January 2011. It sat out on the layout for like all summer. But by August, we noticed that the roof had separated. They used hot glue to manufacture the roof. And it was totally separated and also warped a bit. So we're going to try to fix that over the winter. But that was purchased as brand new, and that's the way it is. The little church was purchased in early October 2011. It came in like garbage in a box. Parts were missing or had fallen off or were broken off by the Chinese guys, apparently, who assembled them. Yes, really quite a mess. Here you can see that the roof totally is loose and lifts up in the back end. Even the back end roof lifts up. And look here in the back. There's a spot where the actual siding on the building is totally missing. We have the parts all right here, and you can see that it's really a mess. It came in as a mess. It was bought brand new, and that was bought from CharlesRowe.com. The U.S. Train's SD70 Mac was purchased at CharlesRowe.com in early April 2011, and it was a real heartbreaker. This train engine left me all summer without a locomotive to run in its place. It was a terrible purchase. What happened was, first of all, the Phoenix sound system on it would not work at lower speeds, would not give braking sounds or idle sounds or startup sounds or any of that. And also, the rear wheels, the rear trucks, fell off this locomotive, causing it to really not run well on the tracks. So over the year, over the summer, I saved up my money and purchased the shipping back to Charles Rowe for the warranty service, and the money for the insurance, which we insured it for $700, because that's, we had about $650 in it. And by the time we got down there, they told us, well, it needs a battery for the Phoenix sound, and it needs to be replaced. And they charged us $20 for the battery and $20 to replace it, and sent it back to us. And still, the Phoenix sound does not work. However, they did get the wheels back on the rear trucks. Yeah, the wheels came off it. But that was another purchase, brand new, from CharlesRowe.com, including installed Phoenix sound system. And the system still does not work to this day. They suggest that we take the sound system and send it back to Phoenix for repair. I'm suggesting I'm not going to do that. I'm going to fix all these items over the season and hopefully have them back up and running for next spring. We'll see how it goes.